So that first minute, they're just like, who is this guy?
Who is this guy? This guy?
And then you can, like, you know, if you're doing well, they'll get into you. But
yeah. What's up, man?
I'm doing all right.
How are you feeling?
I
stopped asking people how you're doing because everyone's doing.
Yeah.
How are you feeling?
I feel good.
Feel good?
No, it's election day. This comes out.
Oh, this will come on election day.
On election day. Look, I wore...
If you're still alive.
We're recording on Halloween. This comes out election day.
Yeah, it's pretty ominous.
Yeah.
This is like the first Halloween I've actually been kind of nervous.
Yeah.
If I'm being real, this is like the first Halloween where I had like actual, not like childlike fear as a kid. But like legitimate adult fear, like, oh, I don't know what's going to happen.
Yeah, the one year where we're not all dressing up as monsters is the year where I'm like, this is actually scary.
Yeah. Did you already vote?
I did.
Yeah, same here.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm not going to tell you who I voted for, but I think you can look at my hair and you'll know.
Yeah, yeah. And you can look at the color of my skin and know. Uh-oh, I am dressed like an American flag.
You are dressed like a red, white, and blue.
Red, white, and blue. You know, because it's Halloween, I dressed up like your friend that's like, can't we all get along?
Yeah. You dressed up for 4th of July 3 months too late.
Yeah.
You're just like, you know, like, I have to celebrate holidays 3 months from now. So you'll celebrate Halloween in February.
Right.
It's like, wow, this guy takes Black History Month a little too far.
Uh-oh.
You still have that bad Halloween.
It's face paint. It's something else. It's something else.
You have that problematic Halloween costume in February. Yeah.
Dude, I had a bud tell me one time. He's like, I dressed up as a skeleton 1 year. And you have to do like black and white face paint, but there's a time where I just had the black face paint on, and he's like
accidental blackface.
Yeah, and he's like, I took a photo, and I was like, why would you take a photo?
No, my friend, I'm not gonna say who because he's a comic, and I respect him, and I know that he's not racist, but he used to do this performance as a robot. So he would dress up as a robot and he would have like silver paint on his face.
Yeah.
So one time he was out of town doing a show and he forgot his silver paint.
Uh-huh.
So he got the closest thing and the paint said silver on it.
Yeah.
But then when he put it on, it just and part of the robot bit is he's doing like breakdancing. Oh.
Wait, could he not? So he still wore it and went out?
He put it on and he was like up next because he doesn't like to put the paint on right away.
Oh.
So it was like still a showcase show.
Yeah.
So he put the paint on. and he does it with this other comic.
Yeah.
And he was just like, bro, no. And he's just looking at the, he's like, we gotta go. So he's just on stage doing the robot.
Just in straight up blackface.
Yeah, and everyone he has the bolts and stuff too. So he just did blackface. But he was like a breakdancing blackface robot.
Like, okay. They're like, this is really weird. It's like a racist, but he's like a robot.
Yeah.
And we're like, I don't know what to make of this.
I was like, you probably look like the Scarecrow from The Wiz. If anything, that's what I told him. You probably look like the Scarecrow from The Wiz, which is, I know that's Michael Jackson, but if you don't know Michael Jackson, you're like, is Michael Jackson doing, like, if you like don't know that like Michael Jackson used to look African-American, then you might be like, yo, this is a little weird, Michael Jackson.
Yeah.
I mean, who's that, who plays Gamora in Guardians of the Galaxy?
Oh, Zoe Saldana?
She played, I forgot what movie it was in. I want to say it was the Roberta Flack movie. I want to say it was that, but I could be wrong. It was the Nina Simone movie, excuse me.
Oh, okay.
I don't think Roberta Flack has a movie, shame. But it was a Nina Simone movie, and Zoe basically, I mean, we'll put a photo up. Mm-hmm. It is weird.
Really?
Because she is black.
Yeah.
But it's like a little bit of shadism. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Like, it's like maybe somebody else should have played this. You know, you don't really like Nina Simone.
Yeah, I like only see her when she's green.
Yeah.
Like, I only see her when she's Gamora.
Dude, there's going to be one day we make contact with aliens. They're going to see all the fucking movies we made about them. And they're going to be like, what the fuck did you think we were? This is so fucked up. We were going to share all this technology with you, cure cancer, cure AIDS, cure racism.
Yeah.
I don't know how technology will cure racism.
Yeah, yeah.
It has not helped us so far. and then they're like, but we're going to leave Earth because this bitch wore green on her face. She did green face.
Yeah, why do you guys think we're green?
Yeah. It's like, we have three titties, but green.
Yeah, yeah.
Come on. So it is election season. And we were talking about, like, first of all, I don't know if you've seen this, but like Lil Wayne just came out and endorsed President Trump.
Oh, that's right. That was in the group text. Yeah.
And everyone freaked the fuck out and like, oh my God, Lil Wayne. It's like, dude, if this was high school, like if this was 2007, this might be a big deal when Lil Wayne was like super fucking relevant. And like, I'm a huge Lil Wayne fan. Mm-hmm. And I think at one point he was the greatest rapper alive, mainstream wise.
Yeah.
And I feel like it's just really funny to see how the hip hop community is freaked out. And I'm always like wondering, like, wouldn't it be funny if like an anime character like endorsed Trump?
Oh, that'd be really like just randomly this season, like this week.
Like if like I like the I have an opinion on who I think would endorse Trump.
Oh, yeah.
Mr. Satan.
Oh, yeah.
Mr. Satan and Trump are very alike.
Yeah, it's that pro wrestling.
Pro wrestling. Yeah.
Talking shit.
Yeah. Just like talk always about themselves. He's like, hi, Mr. Satan here. I want you to make America great again.
People are like, what is this guy's policies? And he rips a phone book in half and you're like, I love it.
I killed Cell.
You're like, did you kill Cell? Or was that the guy before you? Like, I killed Cell.
Come on, man. I hang around these people who are always blonde and blue eyed. Come on.
Really, he's really igniting the base.
Oh, yeah. World champion. Mr. Satan. Make America great again. I think Mr. Satan would endorse Trump.
For sure.
Who do you think would endorse Trump in the anime world?
Who do I think would endorse Trump in the anime world? Donald Trump and Death Note, I think. Which is the perfect...
Listen, there's a lot of bad things out there. They're these Shinigamis. I've seen them. You don't even want to know.
They're terrifying.
They're terrifying. You think Corona's bad? Let me tell you. The god of death.
Dude, Donald Trump, man, you know, he spent $4 trillion just to get the Death Note in the U.S.
Yeah.
What sleepy Joe Biden do?
Did you see that clip of him with talking to a president from Israel?
No.
So, like, he just brokered a peace deal between, I promise we'll get to the anime. Oh, yeah. But he just brokered this peace deal with the Israeli prime minister. And he basically was just like, do you think Sleepy Joe would have done this? Do you think Sleepy Joe would have gotten this deal done? And he's like, this is on a phone call. So he's like looking at the phone call and he's just like, he has this like, oh my God, is he going to endorse me?
Uh-huh.
And then the prime minister of Israel is basically like, well, Mr. President, I think Israel is looking for peace in the world and will take any help from the United States, whoever is president.
Mm-hmm.
And Trump just was like, you can see as he's like saying it, Trump just was like, ugh. Fuck you. You fucking pussy.
Yeah.
Like Trump really wanted to call him a pussy and just be like, the deal's off.
Yeah. He's like, I thought we were in this together. I thought you knew what the deal was.
Like, yeah. Oh my God. It was so funny.
I would love it if that was in the deal where it's like peace. And then it's like at the very bottom, it's like, you have to say Sleepy Joe Biden wouldn't have done this.
Sleepy Joe Biden does feel like an anime character. He feels like, it does feel like the dude from Tower of God who's always trying to take naps. Sleepy Joe wouldn't climb the tower. Just sleeping all the time. Would not help the group. You know, he's probably gonna kill you on the 70th level. Okay, just saying. We were talking about who we think would be the best anime presidential candidate. Who'd you think?
Oh man, who's the best one? I think have you seen Magi?
No, I have not seen Magi.
Sinbad from Magi.
Sinbad. Not the comedian.
He
was never bombed.
You know what?
But would if he was president?
Honestly, you know what? I changed my answer. Sinbad the comedian.
I mean, we've already seen him on the first kid.
Oh, okay.
Was Sinbad in the first kid?
Was that him?
I think it was Sinbad. Am I being racist or was that Shaq with the Shazam thing? I think it's Sinbad. I'm going to look this up right now. Sinbad first kid.
Who else would be a good...
Sinbad wasn't the first kid. I know my Sinbad.
Hell yeah.
Huge Sinbad fan. Shout out to Sinbad. I met him once. Very nice guy.
Uh-huh. Oh, okay.
Yeah. I did. He was very, very nice.
Yeah.
I was like, yo, I'm a comedian. He goes like, yo, keep doing that comedy thing, man. You'll get there.
And he was wearing a shirt with just a bunch of triangles on it, and it's all multicolored.
I try to send the photo so you can see it, but he just was like wearing like a vest. So there's this thing in comedy called the National Association of Campus Activities. It's short for NACA, and you go and perform in front of all these college kids so they can book you so you can perform at their school. And Sinbad, and usually you have to apply, and it's this crazy long process, and then after so many elimination rounds, you finally get to perform.
Yeah.
Sinbad did none of that. Sinbad just showed up and walked around, set up a table, and everyone wanted him.
Right.
I was just like, yo, this is so unfair, but also it is Sinbad.
Yeah.
I was like, I ain't even mad at this. I can't hate.
Yeah, yeah. Dude, that's so funny.
Yeah.
Yeah, just that walk-on attitude.
But you think Sinbad from the Magi anime.
Yeah, he's just like this... he's just a capitalist.
Okay.
It's like a world of war, and he's like the war is bad, but capitalism. It's actually a really good show.
I have it on my list, but I've not watched it yet.
Yeah, it does. It really sneaks in a cool capitalism versus communism, and like pros and cons.
Is Sinbad the main character?
Sinbad's not the main character.
Oh, okay.
He's one of these kings who's like, everyone goes like, oh, he's so like charismatic or whatever.
So he went from a sailor, because I know the real tale of Sinbad is he's like a sailor.
Yeah, it's basically, it's kind of the same. He's the king of the seven seas.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
That's interesting. That's interesting. I would go Simon from Gurren Lagann.
Oh, yeah.
Humble.
Yeah.
Very, very emotional, but he also is compassionate.
Yeah.
And he's I feel like he's a good leader. He was put in jail, so I think he'd be against prison. He'd be for prison reform.
Yeah.
And talk about military. He has a fucking mecha.
He's got a giant.
That can drill to the fucking sky. Yeah. So it's like, yo, I mean, yeah, sure, he's pro-fracking, but I think I can live with that.
Oh, yeah, he loves drilling into stuff.
Drill 2020.
Drill 2020.
You know, I think Simon. I would go with Simon from
Gurren Lagann. That's interesting, yeah. I mean, oh, man, but those assholes trying to throw a coup against him.
Hey, man, you know, he's been through one. He can handle another.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Simon, you got my vote.
Yeah.
That's who I would vote for sure. I would campaign for him.
I think he does a good job.
Yeah. Simon Gurren 2020. That's me right there.
Him and his robot is his vice president.
Yeah. He's a vice president. He's also the Secretary of Defense and the Secretary of State. He's everything. He's the whole cabinet.
Yeah. Yeah, dictator. Here we go.
I guess the biggest news in anime, in the more important news, is that Sony is purchasing Country Roll.
Yeah. Yeah, it's wild. It's because they already own Funimation.
Yeah, yeah.
So now now we get two shitty apps under one country.
Yeah, can you at least fix it? Crunchyroll always dies on my Roku player.
Yeah.
I always have to like reload it two or three times before I can watch a show.
Mm-hmm.
But I do think it's like interesting that they're probably going to have to consolidate the two, or maybe they keep it like separate. You know, like Crunchyroll will be like Coca-Cola. And then, like, Funimation will be, like, the off-brand soda.
Right.
But they're still owned by the same company. You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
I think they might just keep it that way. Or maybe they'll have a plan where you can have both.
Yeah, well, not too long ago. I don't know if you remember. They were both under Warner Brothers or something. And I don't remember Verve.
Verve used to be, like, the thing. But, like, I think that's, like, I don't know if that's still available.
I don't think. Well, because it kind of all fell apart when Sony took away Funimation.
Yeah.
Because it used to be this thing where it's like, oh, it's a one-stop thing. You pay like $7 a month. And all of the, like, pretty much all of the anime services.
Yeah.
And then it kind of all fell apart once Funimation got taken out.
I mean, it is a consolidation.
Mm-hmm.
No matter how you split it, it is a consolidation. It's like they are now the same under the same parent company. My guess is I would assume that Sony or some company would be looking at Shonen next to buy. Because that's a lot of intellectual properties right there.
Yeah.
And I think we are on the beginning of the anime wars.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't mean the anime wars that you can Google and YouTube and you'll see that. You're familiar with the anime wars on YouTube?
No.
So there's this thing called the anime wars. And like it's like these artists who have just taken out easy animation cuts and they just like splice them, so it'll just be like Goku versus Saitama and like this weird demon, and they're all fighting this one weird Genma kind of looking guy. Who like, it's like all these characters that don't, that are not in the same universe getting together to shoot beams at him.
Yeah.
And they don't make, they don't have any plot whatsoever. That's just like fighting.
Yeah.
It's just, they're all just fighting for some reason or another. And, but this is the actual anime wars of like people like trying to buy these properties. And I'm so confident someone's going to buy Shonen Jump coming down the line.
Yeah. I don't, yeah, that would be really interesting, because then you get all the IPs and you get all the, you can license it to whoever you want.
Whoever you want, because I think that like they're starting to realize how popular anime is becoming, and it's just so cheap to make. I mean, if you think about it, they bought Crunchyroll for barely a billion dollars, less than $1 billion.
Yeah.
Demon Slayer fans are just like, only a billion?
A billion yen. Oops.
You talk to us when it's 10 times.
Right.
Nah, but it's like less than $1 billion, which isn't that crazy if you think about it.
Yeah, for like, I mean, you know, it's crazy to say, but on that like scale of a purchase, it's like, you know, it's not, it's a pretty good deal.
I think they're coming out like looking really good.
Yeah. Because
they're going to be able to like turn all these, like, especially like if you look at the Crunchyroll originals, like Tower of God could easily become a live action thing. So could God of High School. Don't do it. Could easily become a live action thing. That property that Sony makes. So I would assume that coming down the line, you're going to see a lot more of these properties being bought up and being just like under these blankets of like different companies. I don't know if that's good necessarily. I think.
Yeah, well, we were talking about it last week, and it's just coming, I mean, it's obviously coming right off the heels of Netflix. Making deals with more and more studios.
Yeah.
So it is this weird, it's kind of becoming the story as it's always told, which is like a few big companies kind of control everything.
I guess my fear is just for the creators. I just like hope that like this like allows them to be free and like they can collaborate with one another. It's not like you get stuck under one house or one studio and then you can't work with other people. I don't know how the business is right now, but I know whenever it's just those big companies, it just gets harder and harder to like make interesting art in that regard.
Yeah, and it's harder to improve the terrible working conditions, which it's like, has been like, you know, it's been a big problem recently that's been slowly being addressed, but like if you get kind of thrown under these big corporate umbrellas, I don't know how much better.
Yeah, and I wonder how hard it is for people who are like making those webtoons. Is it going to be like, is it going to affect your market in that regard? And like, I don't want to talk too much shop in that regard, but it's just like, I know animation is super competitive in America, so I can imagine how much, I mean, it's such a big deal in Japan. So I would assume that like, for the creators and the animators and the people who write the stories, they're at the end of the day the ones going to get shafted. And that's just my fear. Like, I hope that like it's not, it doesn't become that like Netflix is like, well, we'll make this show, but this is your budget. And at the end of the day, they don't make that much money. And then the product comes out super shitty. And then the fandom is the one that just eats them alive. And they don't really understand like the politics that's going on behind the scenes.
Yeah. Which I think they're trying to do more and more awareness about it, but it is, I don't know. It could just go, you go like, all right. Oh, because for us, we just go, oh, anime is easier and easier to consume. And then
it makes it harder to make for the actual people.
Yeah, for the actual people.
Like care about that shit.
Right.
Who make it.
Yeah.
And, I mean, we'll see. I mean, we'll see. I mean, speaking of Netflix, they came out with an anime.
An anime this week.
Blood of Zeus.
Blood of Zeus.
Which tells the story, the original Shonen story.
The original Greek.
Heron and like Zeus and the gods, and it's about a boy who doesn't know he's powerful, doesn't know that who his real dad is. It's like, sound familiar to you? It's like, oh, we can call this an anime. It's like, nigga, this is a cartoon. This is a cartoon, bro.
This is a cartoon.
Yeah, there's no bloody nose. No one bloody nose. There's no funny. Yeah. It was not funny at all.
No, not at all.
Yeah, I mean, I thought it was cool. What'd you think of it?
I really was just like, who cares? I was just watching it being like, this is coming from, I like Castlevania, which
I love
is
Castlevania.
The same studio. Yeah. I forget their name. I'll throw it up.
We'll throw it up. Yeah.
So this was just kind of like a disappointment. I just sort of wasn't really super into any one part of it.
I thought it was fine. I didn't hate it, but I don't think I'll watch season two.
Yeah.
I thought, like, I mean, it's a basic story of, like, any Greek. They take the Greek character Zeus, Hera, Poseidon, Heron, a couple, like, monsters in there here and there, and the Titans. And they basically just, like, rearrange certain characters. We're not going to go too deep into this, but, like,
yeah.
I thought it was, like, entertaining enough. I kind of liked the gods the most because I was just like, oh, y'all are messy. It felt like I was watching, like an episode of Mari with powers. Just like Zeus being like, yo, yeah, here's more of my one bastard son. I want you to protect my other bastard son.
Yeah. What is great? The stakes are so crazy because, I mean, whatever. Zeus cheats on his wife Hera, and that kind of sets off this whole thing.
I love that Zeus hooked up with a woman who was married, and the only way he hooked up with her was pretending to be her husband.
Yeah.
And it's like, what a way to, it's like, how far do you have to go to gaslight somebody? Yeah, you know what I mean?
Dude, I think we can, if we're going to be a little bit of the woke police right now, I feel like we can knock off some points right here where it's like, he's pretending to be someone else when they have sex. They're showing the main villain is a woman who's mad that she got cheated on, so she decides to end. So she decides to end the world.
Well, to be fair to her, she does have it pretty under control.
Yeah,
because she has like this mechanism that can control the Titans. That's so right, she knows what she's doing. Yeah, she just needs to knock off Zeus and then she'll send them back.
Yeah,
that's her whole thing. Yeah, yeah. I mean, she's just using the Titans.
Yeah,
like
yeah.
It's not even like too. She's not wrong.
No,
there's like no part of me that watches her. And I'm like, this bitch.
Yeah, but I kept expecting there to be like some master plan. Be like, this is actually the world I wanted to live in the whole time. But it's really just like, yeah, I'll bring these giants back into the fold just because you fucked another woman.
Yeah, it's like also like look at all these other sons. He's like fucked around a ton.
Yeah,
like there was like no real like legitimate motivation.
Yeah.
For the entire thing, mm-hmm. It just was so whack to me. It just was like the story itself. It's a lot of like glitter porn because at one point when the funniest part to me, the entire show that made, and I know they were trying to make it look cool, but like Zeus, they show like Zeus and Hera defeating one of the Titans and he just puts his hand up like he's a 70s disco star and thunder goes through this Titan and he's holding her and looking at her and I just was like, this is so corny.
Dude, there's a couple whole unintentionally hilarious just spoilers.
Yeah. I mean, don't watch it.
Yeah, we're not super into it.
It's fine at best.
Yeah. When, what's his face? Heron kills Seraphim.
Yeah.
When he sticks the spear through him, it does the tripled up the audio of no.
I did notice that. Like, that was weird.
I love it when they did it. It's like, it really feel like they didn't earn the from three different angles.
No, not at all. Not at all. I don't know why they wanted to call it an anime so bad.
Yeah.
Because I think they're just trying to be like, it's anime, you'll watch it. And that, I mean, it did work, but the reason I watched it because I was like, they're calling this so much an anime. And I feel like we have to talk about like how they're trying to make everything anime now.
Uh-huh.
Where some things I'm like, this is just CGI. It's just a CGI cartoon. This is essentially, this is like Ben 10. Like,
yeah.
I don't, not to shit on Ben 10. I never watched it, but it's just like, this isn't like, you're not going to like make me think this is an anime just because
it's
a cartoon.
I don't know what happened because I feel like Castlevania is animated so well.
It is. It's very much so.
I don't know why this was so like, kind of like staticky and, I feel like the fights are just like, you know, it's like there's a guy with a whip, but he's not doing cool whip stuff like they're doing in Castlevania.
That guy. It's like, were you guys human traffickers?
I think so.
Yeah.
Just like, really, they just sprinkle them in and they're like, all right.
Yeah, we're human traffickers. You know, we're trying to make amends for the fucked up shit we did. So we'll be good guys now. It's like, wait, no.
Mm-hmm.
You guys are pieces of shit.
Yeah.
It's just like, yo, like, I don't know. It was fine. I'm not trying to shit on it because I know a lot of people worked hard on this.
Yeah.
But I just, once you put anime on it, it's like, we see what you're doing.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, it was like the top 10 most watched thing in the United States.
Yeah, I think it's still up there, yeah.
I would be interested to see what people in Japan thought of it, but I wonder if they didn't even call it an anime in Japan.
I don't know what you would call it. my whole feelings for it can be described up in a gif mm-hmm. of from this show,
yeah,
which is when the giants come back and they're in the water. Poseidon's just like checking out. He's like, sticks his head out from under the sea, checks it out, and then just goes right back under. he just goes right back under the water.
I think that's a good way to put it. Yeah. I'm like, I don't think I'm going to watch. I only watched the whole thing because I was like, we should talk about this. But I thought it was... Yeah. Don't watch it.
Look, it's American. It's U.S. Election Day. Yeah. We got to talk about something American.
We
got to
talk about American anime.
We got to talk about American animation.
Yeah, it's like that video of those people talking about like Akira if it was shown in America. It's like, what up, Canada? I think we'll put that in the description, but it's like the most like they're just trying to make it for Western audiences. Like, nah, trust me, just make it the way it's supposed to be intended. Yeah. Like, I don't have a problem with the stories of the gods being told because it's true. A lot of Japanese storytellers do borrow from the Greek stories, and that's fine. Mm-hmm. But they remodel it so it can fit anime tropes, and that's also fine. But the idea that you're gonna like, you know, first of all, that's not an American property.
Yeah.
But it's like to be like, we'll just put anime on it, and what are you gonna do about it? It's like, nah, you should like respect the art form,
right?
So. Yeah.
Absolutely. Now,
I bucked at the camera.
onto a show we do like.
Jujutsu Kaisen.
Jujutsu Kaisen.
I think this latest episode was the best one. And I know we might be saying that every week.
I think we do say that every week. But this one was really cool.
Yeah.
And not just because we finally get to see the panda.
We did get to see the panda.
We finally get to see the panda.
And his name is just Panda.
That was so funny.
That was so funny.
Yeah.
I guess you want to set up what, just a quick recap.
Yeah, where we left off.
Sukuna goes to confront, I always forget this dude's name.
Yeah, Megumi, but it's like Fushiguro. I think Megumi's his first name.
Megumi is his first name. Mm-hmm. And we get this quick quip about this first name. Yeah. Megumi, but what's his last name? Because I was
Fushiguro.
Sometimes they'll call him Megumi, and then other times they'll call him Fushiguro. Mm-hmm. So I'm just like, and I know that's his last name.
Yeah.
And it's a little confusing because this show will do a bounce and forth. Usually they'll be like, yo, it's Midoriya.
Right.
And you don't use the Izuku. You're like, it's Midoriya. Mm-hmm. So it's like, sometimes I'll be like, Megumi, and I'm like, wait. I thought you were...
Yeah, I guess they're not like familiar.
That's enough. True.
Because you know, you go by last name until like your buds.
Yeah, that's a good point. I'm going to call him Megumi because it's funnier.
Because it's a girl's name.
It's a girl's name. You a girl.
It's just one of those funny, like, just thrown in a dramatic flashback. He's like, oh, my dad who gave me a girl's name. You're like, what? Why is this right before you die?
Yeah.
You're thinking about, like, I can't believe I have a girl's name.
Well, I think I understand why he brought that up. And it was funny. It made me laugh. But, I mean, just starting up the fight, Sukuna comes out and it's just like, yo, your boy ain't coming back. I'm going to kill you.
Yeah.
But first of all, I want to see what you can do. And, I mean, we get to kind of see him flex his muscle a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
And the first thing he does is he sets out the bird, Nui.
Yeah.
Can we talk about this bird real quick?
Uh-huh.
Why does it look like the scariest owl from Hogwarts? Yeah, like if that shit came to my window, I'd be like, nah, I ain't a wizard. Put me back in the fucking closet, doc. It looks like Hagrid fucked an owl.
Yeah.
It really looks like Hagrid fucked an owl, bro. Yeah. It's like, oh yeah, Harry, you're a wizard, but don't look at that kid.
<New way. laughs>
Like really, I was just like, yo, this owl is fucking... like gnarly looking dog, like for real.
Yeah, it's got a crazy mask
and like its wingspan. Yeah. I do love that at one point Megumi is like in trouble and the owl picks him up and you see his face and he's just like, he's like, we're gonna die.
Fuck.
He just clenches like, oh my gosh.
I just saw my snake friend explode.
Yeah, at one point the fucking Sukuna says like, yo, next time you hit me, put some curse in it.
Yeah.
And Megumi is just like, all right, here's my blue true. Bam! Yeah. Fucking Anaconda comes up, bites that dude, and then him and the bird are just like smacking it up across each other. And I'm like, oh, this is gonna do some damage. Nothing. Uh-uh. Absolutely nothing.
Yeah, not even a little.
It's like, ah, you came too early, dog. Couldn't hold it in. Yeah. He's like, gotta get out of here. Sukuna just beats the shit out of dude.
Yeah.
Beats the shit out of him. and he's like toying with him. It's like just kicking him around the like the fucking buildings. At one point, there's like he just like you see him flying through a window with plates, yeah. And I'm like, wow, someone's dinner is ruined.
All like the buildings and stuff that like got destroyed. It's like yeah. How are they gonna explain this?
Oh, property damage. That should be the name of this episode. Yeah. We're like, yo, property damage. Insurance is going up.
Right.
Your neighborhood's about to get gentrified.
When Scooter comes around.
Yeah, when Scooter comes around. Sakuna, we saw the last episode, the last dude was a home interior decorator.
Yeah.
Sakuna is a That's real estate right. developer.
Yeah.
He was like, I think I want to see a park there. Yeah. Condominium there. Ooh, subway. Right. Gotta have a subway.
Oh, man. Yeah. He's just rezoning everything.
Yeah, but then I think I really like this part, and I wrote this down, and I want to make sure I want to get this right, is you get Megumi's, I don't want to say manifesto. What's a good way to put this?
His
outlook on life.
Oh, my God. Yeah.
He's like, the only thing guaranteed to us is like reality is unfair.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, oh, that's such a great thing. And he's like, everyone's just a cogs in a system. And you kind of see a brief glimpse of his, I think his ex-girlfriend or someone he loved in his life.
Yeah, I couldn't tell if that was his mom or sister or girlfriend.
I hope it's his mom.
Dude, yeah.
Because it's like, oh, you really hate your dad. This dude hates his father.
Yeah, yeah.
He's like, my dad is a piece of shit who gave me this girl-ass name.
Yeah.
And my mom is dead. And mm-hmm. my dad is now living a pleasant life, and I'm out here killing these curses.
Right. So he basically goes, he's like, I only want to help good people.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, and it kind of explains why he mm-hmm. saved Itadori.
Yeah, yeah.
And then it kind of like wakes Itadori up.
Mm-hmm.
And then he dies. He pulls an Aaron Yeager.
He dies.
Just like, thanks, man. Live a long life. It's like, you ain't dead.
Well, it's so funny. Last week, I think we were like, yeah, you know, he'll have like a, like, oh, he had a heart attack, but he did it.
Yeah.
And then literally his heart gets pulled out of him. Yeah. He's like, he's dead. But
not really.
Yeah.
It was cool to see Sensei Gojo come back mm-hmm. and like be kind of like, it was like the first time you kind of saw him show any real emotion.
Yeah.
Because I felt like he was just like, I'm an OP.
Mm-hmm.
And nothing bums me out. But then seeing Itadori die, I don't know if it was because he liked the kid or if he was like, nah, my plan's ruined.
Right.
I wanted to kill this guy.
Yeah, that's the only way we can do it.
I'm mad because I didn't get to kill him.
Yeah. Yeah, well, he's upset because I think he knows the only reason he can't save someone is because he wasn't there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He was out having mm-hmm. his own bizarre adventure.
Yeah. Gojo's bizarre adventure.
Yeah. It was interesting. And then you kind of saw Kitsuburi and Megumi just kind of like being bummed out.
Mm-hmm.
Bummed out that Itadori's dead. Dead.
Quotes.
And then you get to meet
The second years,
which I guess is their big three.
Yeah.
If you want to like do the My Hero comparison.
Uh-huh.
Which was cool. Two of them had a bigger impact for me.
Yeah.
Do you want to guess which ones?
I'm going to guess Panda.
Obviously.
Panda Senpai.
Yes.
And a guy who only speaks in salmon roll.
Inumaki.
That's his name. Yeah.
I wrote him down because I love that he writes only speaks in ingredients of rice balls.
I know. Well, because Panda shows up and he kind of almost immediately gets overshadowed by this guy that's just being like salmon.
Yeah. I was like, oh, okay. I didn't think I was going to like you more than Panda.
Right.
But I do like the joke of like, wait, you're not going to explain why this panda's a panda?
Yeah, they're like, he can only speak in this. She's the yada yada.
Yeah.
That's Panda.
That's Panda. And they're like, oh, wait, what?
Wait a second.
And then the guy says salmon. Like, wait, what? Yeah. And then this girl, Zenin, I just wanted to make sure I gave her some shine. They're all pretty funny. I'm like, mm-hmm. oh, you guys are interesting. I love how like the dynamic between you guys. You're an interesting trio. And then they introduced the idea that there are other schools.
Yeah. Kyoto,
yeah. I'm interested to see the other schools. I love that like there's different schools for Jujutsu sorcerers.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, oh, there's got to be a Harvard a Jujutsu sorcerer. There's also like one that's like Trump University.
Yeah. It's also funny because I think there's about 9 students in each school. It's
yeah.
Like, why don't you all just go to the same school?
It's like, why are you having a... It's like, we got to have a tournament arc.
Yeah.
We just want to have a tournament arc.
That's exactly what it is.
Like, and we can't do it within the schools. It's like, we got to have some... We want to introduce characters you've never seen before.
Yeah. Dude, that's so funny. You can almost tell it's like when... I don't know the guy who or lady who is the author.
Yeah.
But it's just funny. It's like the early manga things where you're like, okay, I kind of got people hooked a little bit. How do I keep them here? Tournament arc.
Yeah. And it's just like, even the way they were describing it, they're like, well, one school gets to pick an activity, but it's really just a whatever, get into a battle. Whatever. Yeah. And then I feel like the craziest part is I feel like we can get to see the big bads. Some of the big bads.
Yeah, we saw some human talking with some curses.
Did they say his name at all? I don't think we got to know his name.
I don't think so.
I don't know if they did. But he was talking to some curses. You kind of get the curses point of view of like, we are manifestations of pure emotion, so we're more pure than humans. Mm-hmm. Therefore, we should inhabit the earth, not humans.
Yeah.
And then he kind of gives them a game plan on how to beat the humans.
Yeah.
He's like, you got to get Gojo not to fight and able to fight. Mm-hmm. And then you got to get Itadori and Sukuna to join your side.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
So it's an interesting dynamic. Mm-hmm. Obviously Itadori is going to come back the next two episodes.
Yeah. It seems like there's gonna be some sort of internal struggle.
Yeah.
Maybe him and Sukuna kind of get on terms.
Yeah. It feels like they're going to make a deal. And then they'll probably come back. Sukuna's probably going to be like, listen, I get weekends. I get to do whatever I want on weekends.
Yeah.
5 days a week, we'll do your savey bullshit. But the weekends, yeah. I kill
people. Not your friends. I won't kill your friends.
Just can't we kill one person?
Megumi is just like, as long as they're bad.
Yeah.
as long as it's my dad. If it's my dad, okay.
Does he have a license? Yeah. If he has a license, he can't do it.
Dude, all week I've been driving without a license. I've been going wild.
Megumi must be like, this piece of shit must die. Yeah. He's an inadequate cog in the machine.
That actually does kind of go back to last week. I actually didn't realize that. Yeah, that's why he hates that.
That's why he hates that kid.
That kid, he's like, I don't give a shit about this kid.
He's like, if you're a bad guy, I mean, I don't know if I would constitute somebody driving without a license as evil. And I have a personal vengeance against people who drunk drive. Mm-hmm. But if there was someone who's drunk driving with a license or without a license, I would not give a shit.
Yeah, yeah.
I wouldn't be like, and he didn't have a license.
He didn't have a license.
And that was the episode, man. Dude, this show keeps getting better and better, dog.
Yeah, I mean, it's just like the fight animation is great. I love the character developments. Every little like morsels we keep getting.
I will say that it did kind of fake us out when you thought you were gonna see Megumi fight Sukuna with his true strength. Yeah. 'Cause Sukuna got excited. Mm-hmm. I was like, oh, let's go.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, I was, like, in my seat, like, okay, we're about to see some shit.
Yeah.
Because, like, the fucking aura was coming out of him. Mm-hmm. And I was like, yes, let's fucking go. I'm about to see some eyes. My eyes are about to fall out of my fucking face.
Yeah.
And then you see it go down, and I'm like, oh, I thought at first he lost energy. Mm-hmm. But then the reveal.
Yeah.
I thought that was smart.
I think that was a cool way to, like, you don't see Itadori's face coming back.
Yes.
You don't see like Sukuna fading.
Yes.
But you just see Fushiguro like drop his guard.
Yes.
First.
Yes.
And I think that was like a cool way to like reveal
that.
I thought that
was a cool way too. And it made me go like, you are saving it for something better.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know what that is, but at this point, 5 out of 5 episodes, you've killed it.
Yeah.
So I don't think I can like be, I trust your judgment mm-hmm. in this part. Like, and that's like kind of a fun moment to have when you're like, oh, I trust this show now.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, I think I'm in it for the 24 episodes. I think you're, like, I don't know if there will be one that I'm like, what the fuck was that? But, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's going on all cylinders. I'm sure, you know, they got to slow down eventually, but I think they're doing, yeah. I think I'm in. I like the world, and I just want to know more about it.
I just love that the guy went to the restaurant by himself, and he's just surrounded by curses.
Yeah.
And like, it's like, table for one? He's like, yeah. And he's like, wait. Are people just looking around like, yo, why is this guy who's dressed like a monk talking to him?
You guys having a full-on conversation?
Yeah. Does he have a sword? Yeah. Did he walk up with a sword?
Oh, I don't know.
I thought he had like a weapon. Maybe I got to rewatch that part. But I was just like, whoa, hold on. Like, he's like, one please.
And then one please.
They just walk in.
And yes, the key to making curses take over the world. People are like, what?
You know, everyone's just like that would be really funny if they showed Shulman just eating and being like, what the fuck is this guy talking about? Holy shit.
Yeah, yeah.
It's like, I'm not coming here anymore.
Mm-mm.
And then
this week.
This week.
The show we're going to go do a deeper dive into.
Yeah.
Is Erased.
Erased.
And what'd you think of it?
I love Erased.
You love Erased.
Yeah, I really like it. Yeah, yeah.
I wish I could erase my memory and never watch this anime. I hate this anime.
Oh, damn.
Hard, tough, like, interesting. Hot take. Bad anime.
Oh, wow.
Bad anime. Cool concept.
Yeah, cool concept.
Cool moments.
Yeah.
Overall bad.
Interesting.
Yes.
Yeah, what Well, I'm curious to hear your,
let me talk about what I liked
about
the anime. The opening intro is so good.
It is really good.
This is one of the few animes I watched every single opening intro moment.
Yeah.
And it's so good. The music is good. I think it kind of tells the whole story. Mm-hmm. Like right away, you're like, "Well, that guy's it."
Well, that is a big complaint about it.
Yes,
what kind of almost goes back to Blood of Zeus too, where it's like spoilers and thumbnails, and that happened in Blood of Zeus, where you like is spoilers effective? Like, what are those guys are brothers?
Yeah,
like the thumbnail, like they put them like their split face. You're like, oh
yeah, that's true. I didn't even pay attention to that.
Yeah, and then like the thumbnails for like Erased are like. The bad guy.
I will say this about Blood of Zeus.
Yeah.
One thing that did do really cool was that every single cold open was interesting.
Mm-hmm.
Like the way that like they would like the Blood of Zeus title card would show up. I was like, oh, that's kind of cool. Yeah, that's interesting. Yeah, yeah. They're like kind of setting the tone for each episode.
Mm-hmm.
I thought that was cool. But I love the beginning of the intro episodes of Erased or the intro to Erased. I thought it was so good.
Mm-hmm.
Like, definitely one of the best. I immediately asked you to send me the song on Spotify. It's on my playlist, Bops.
Yeah.
I will definitely be using it to run when I exercise. Super fucking good.
Mm-hmm.
And that is all I liked about
it. That's all you liked about it.
It's like not playing. Animation was great.
The animation's great.
Animation's beautiful.
A1 pictures.
Beautiful animation.
Mm-hmm.
I don't like the story.
Okay.
I thought the story itself was kind of clunky.
Mm-hmm.
Like the way they set up the power he has.
And yeah.
And I guess we should, spoiler already, but in the story, our main character has the ability to go back 5 minutes or a few seconds sometimes to correct a wrong that happens in the world.
Yeah.
My problem is that I never, and I don't know if I missed this, do we ever find out how he got that power?
No, it's just sort of like this. He has this ability and that's it.
That was just like a threat. I'm like, wait, this nigga can time travel. You got to tell me how he figured out time travel.
Well, it's kind of like it's not up to him. It's sort of like it's like a thing that's like a sort of just thrust upon him. And then he has to like...
why him?
Well, this comes back to it's like a point where I don't know. Are you typically a guy who like needs to know, like kind of get a little more of that background of like, oh, the powers, why they have it, kind of thing.
I kind of need to know like what, like if you're going to build this world, you got to justify it. And the logic needs to make sense.
Yeah.
It can't just be like, because he was in close proximity of the events. Mm-hmm. I'm like, yeah. And I think the manga does do a better job of this.
Because I
looked into like the differences between the manga and the anime. Mm-hmm. But you shouldn't have to do that for an anime to be good in my opinion.
No, you shouldn't. Yeah.
I will say this. And obviously, I think the concept of the story was really great. And I think the idea that this guy has this power to be able to go back in time gets a little Minority Report thing going on, and I hate that title. But not all jokes aside, like I like the idea of like, oh, this guy can go back in time for a few minutes to turn things back to normal. I think that's pretty dope. I think a lot of stories have done that kind of stuff in the past. My thing is though, like those stories set up the logic better, and it just felt kind of clunky the way the logic was set up as like this guy can time travel.
Yeah, I think it is really just one of those premises where they just go, this is how it works, and that's all you need to know. Because I don't think the power really affects the story other than that. Because it's basically like once. So I don't know if we said it. So he can go back 5 minutes normally, but then after his mom is murdered, he suddenly finds himself in his 10-year-old body.
Yes,
like he like went back in time all the way to when he was 10.
Yes,
and now he's put in this position to solve this string of murders that happened in his hometown.
Yeah, a string of murders with three girls, or two girls, one boy that looked like a girl.
Yeah.
and that's one thing I'm going to talk about, like, later when we reveal who was the killer.
Yeah.
Is that logically that doesn't make sense.
Oh, I can defend it, but I...
Okay. Yeah. I think you know where I'm going with this.
Yeah, yeah.
But okay. Yeah, you got to defend this anime.
Defend a race.
You got to defend this race. I understand, and I am willing to buy, because it's like you are setting up this world of that this guy can go back in time a few seconds or a minute or two. Mm-hmm. But then he goes back so many years after his mom dies. I can use a little bit of leap of logic to be like, something really traumatic set it forward even further back.
Yeah.
And also the connective tissue of, like, some of these people died and their mom died. It's the same killer. I can kind of buy that.
Mm-hmm.
It's a little bit of a leap, but I can buy it. Yeah, I will buy it.
Yeah, yeah.
And I like the idea. And I was interested when I was like, oh, so this kid's going to try to stop this murder
mm-hmm.
by befriending this girl.
Yeah.
And I'm like, okay. My problem with that is... Your mom is a journalist. Or is she not a journalist yet back then?
She's already retired.
She's retired.
Yeah.
She's already a retired journalist.
Yeah, I don't know what she does.
Tell your mom. Your mom seems to, like, love you and respect you. Tell your mom.
Yeah.
That was the entire time I was like, this doesn't make any sense. This kid still is 27 in his body.
Mm-hmm.
He knows his mom, who his mom is.
Yeah.
Your mom's a busybody know-it-all. Involve her in this investigation.
Yeah.
Well,
I think that's actually one of the big themes of the show is he, from the beginning, goes, I think it's kind of what the show is about in general, where it's like, he's like, oh, I have to do this by myself. If I tell people I have the superpower, no one's going to believe me. All this stuff. No one's going to go into it. And as the show goes on, he realizes I can't do this by myself. The only way I can do it is by relying on my mom to help with the child protection services. The only way I can, I have to rely on my friends to keep an eye on, like, these other potential victims.
I get that.
Yeah.
But I guess for me, the entire time I was just like, the mom you set up in the beginning, if you had set up the mom differently, I would buy that. But that mom would have been like, oh yeah, I believe you.
Yeah.
His mom, cause his mom's like, could mind read him the entire time.
Right.
So it's like, his mom was like, she knew her son.
Yeah.
So if her son was like, and also there was a one moment where he was talking about this place that he had been to
mm-hmm.
and how beautiful it was. He's like, you never been there. If he had just been like, yeah, I have, because I'm 27 and I time traveled.
I am
and
a
I can
superhero.
Prove it,
yeah,
and
yeah,
I
yeah.
can do all these things. I can show you all these things.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You could have easily just saved, mm-hmm. like, that's where the logic kind of bumps me.
Yeah, I think.
I think the mom character needed to change.
So like, she's like a little less capable?
A little bit less, maybe not a reporter, because that didn't really come into play at all. If I'm being real.
Yeah, just the fact that her partner.
Yeah, yeah, but you didn't need him.
Yeah, really, not really.
Like, again, no disrespect to the show.
Yeah.
But, like, you didn't really need him to push the story forward. Mm-hmm. You could have found other dynamics to do that.
Uh-huh.
And you could have still kept the integrity of the mom and made that string along. Because I thought the mom dynamic was really dope, because he was kind of shitty towards her
mm-hmm.
when she was around, when she first was introduced.
Mm-hmm.
And then he kind of, like, saw her again, and he was like, I mean, I miss these dinners. And that made me almost cry.
Yeah,
that moment with the dinner with the mom, I was like, oh man. And I'm seeing my mom this weekend specifically because of that.
Oh really?
Yeah, I was like, man, I gotta go see mom.
So it did something good.
It did something good. Again, I don't think I'm exaggerating. It's not a bad anime. Yeah, honestly, I'd give it like a 6 out of 10.
Look, this is for entertainment. We gotta be
controversial.
We gotta get that thumbnail.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Opie, like, this is gonna be the picture.
A race.
Fuck, a race.
Is a race the fucking worst?
but it does do some great moments. Like that fox scene, amazing. I love that scene.
Yeah, it is very beautiful.
Yes. And like the way, I still think the plan of trying to be her friend could have been cool. And even if you told the mom could have been like, all right, we gotta be delicate about this.
Mm-hmm.
And the mom could have like activated her. If you activate the mom and then the mom activates the son and be like, here's what I think you should do. I think this still works.
Yeah, yeah.
But it was just like kind of clunky how you got there, I thought. It just kind of like made me go like, I don't know. Like, this doesn't, Like when I see stuff like that in stories, I'm just kind of like, and maybe because I'm a storyteller myself, and people are going to look at my shit when it comes, if it ever comes out, they're going to be like,
oh, you talk about your story. It was a little clunky, Opie.
Yeah. So, you know, I should be kinder. I'm sorry.
No. I mean, look, this is what the whole thing is supposed to be about.
Yeah.
I mean, we shit on Blood of Zeus. We got to be equal opportunities. Yeah, we got to be equal opportunity here.
Yeah. Blood of Zeus fans are like, USA. USA.
Oh, Ray sucks.
American anime.
It was a little sus.
Oh, well, there's parts that you can't really, so he's a 29-year-old in a 10-year-old's body.
Yeah.
So, and then he starts sort of having like, he sort of unintentionally gets like romantic feelings for like one of his classmates.
Yeah.
But it's like, he's always like, hey,
you're 29.
You're 29.
Yeah. And I'm like, you didn't have to. That did not have to be.
Yeah.
That was not, unless you explored it further, which I'm glad you didn't. that didn't need multiple beats.
No.
He went to it like three times, and I'm like, yeah. Dog, I got it the first time. Mm-hmm. It's weird. But I didn't need that dynamic between y'all two.
Yeah, I'm not defending it.
Yeah.
I'll put it in.
Try to.
But here I go.
Canceled comedian.
Excellent.
It's just filler, no canon anymore.
They're trying to be like, it's not his body. Like he has a 10-year-old body. So it's like, that's like what, but it's like,
I'm just saying,
it's uncomfortable.
I'm just saying at that point, I'm like, this is why you work at a pizza restaurant. You're getting a little pizza gatey, doggy.
Yeah.
I just was like, bro, I did not need that in this. Mm-hmm. And that kind of made me go I was like, if they do this a little bit further, I'm going to stop watching this.
Oh yeah.
Cause I just was getting a little uncomfortable.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I think my biggest problem with the entire anime was the villain. It was like obvious from the beginning.
Yeah, the way the camera sort of like hangs on him.
Yeah,
it's just too much. Like, there's a way to do this to like kind of include him in the story.
Yeah,
but like not make it so obvious that like
because I thought he was a red herring the entire time. I was like, mm-hmm. It's either he's a red herring or like they did not care. They want you to know who it is, and mm-hmm. like because it's like to build tension. Because sometimes a good dynamic will be like showing a bomb, but then our protagonists don't see it, and they're like, oh, I'm scared for the protagonist that you care about.
Yeah.
But you knew he was the bomb, and it was 12 episodes. I'm like, all right, well, when's this bomb going to go off?
Yeah, exactly.
Like, come on. Like, just, like, be a murdering pedophile. Just do it now. I just want you to kill this person, because, like, this is annoying me now.
Yeah, and I will say, it's like, I don't think, I can't speak for the creator, but I think it's maybe not, I don't know how surprising it's supposed to be, because you do find out it's him like 2/3 of the way through,
which is fine.
Yeah. So
but
it's like,
I knew who it was episode 2.
Yeah. Yeah.
So that's where I get the problem is for mm-hmm. me. It's just like, well, you kind of know who it was because this guy is like too perfect.
I agree. I think if they hit it a little more, that moment when you go like, oh shit.
Do you know what would have been great if it was? The mom.
If it was the mom, I'd have been like, yo, I did not see that coming. Whoa.
She killed herself in the future.
Yeah, she with guilt.
Yeah.
If she had like multiple personality or something.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, I mean, not that, but like, if it was like the mom, I'd have been like, yo.
Whoa.
Or like, because they even tried to tease it was like his friend a little bit.
A little bit.
It's because in the opening sequences, you can see everyone's eyes being crossed out, but mm-hmm. it was so the teacher.
Yeah, the problem was there was never another compelling suspect.
Yes.
If there was like another person, then you could kind of have everything as is, as long as there was another equally compelling suspect, but there just kind of wasn't.
Yeah, because like you thought maybe it was her mom or maybe her mom's boyfriend. And you're just like, nah, those are too like obvious. And there's not a real, like they're already beating her. Like why would they like just kill her? Like they're already trying to hide her bruises. It's like harder to hide a body.
Yeah.
And then... Yeah, I don't know, man. Like you just knew it was a teacher, and then I'm cool. I will say the reveal of who was the killer was good. That scene was good.
I think those are kind of. I think the last like three episodes are really, I like those episodes a lot because it's kind of like, it's all the cards on the table.
Yeah.
And now it's just about like this little cat and mouse game between the two of them.
Yeah. And this is where I think a lot of people are on board with my argument of why this anime sucks, is that the ending.
Oh, what about it?
I hated it.
Oh yeah.
I really hated the ending because it was just like, wait, that was your plan? What if he didn't reach for you? Like,
oh, well, like, I think you would have fallen.
And then the guy would have gotten for free, away for free.
Wait.
Because at the end, he's the one who rolls himself off the.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it was like, if he hadn't reached for you. Just
oh,
like,
because it's like an attempted murder.
Yeah.
Because he like lets him go. Because
he lets him go is the attempted murder part.
Oh.
So
he
would have just been like, all right, cool. You just did all my work for me.
Yeah.
Or and then if you fell into the parachute, you're like, all right, we're just back at square one. I'll kill you another time.
Yeah.
And this time I'll be even more careful.
Right.
And I'll kill everybody else who's on that parachute. Yeah. Who's looking down? All right, cool. I got you. All y'all dead. All y'all are dead.
Yeah.
All y'all are fucking.
yeah. Yeah, I guess I didn't really think about it.
Yeah, because it's like, if you think about the plan he had, was he regained his memories when he saw the girl grown up.
Mm-hmm.
So he was aware, and I don't know, it just kind of wasn't like a good reveal. I felt like that, like, he had changed his personality and, like, you know what I mean? It just kind of like felt kind of like I was saying back. It just felt kind of clunky.
Uh-huh.
And just kind of felt expository. And even just being like, the reason I didn't kill you all these years was that you were the only one who knew me for me.
Yeah.
And I just was like, I don't really connect the allegory that you have about the Buddha saving this guy from hell to all of this, to the spider, to the hamster, to the gnat. I'm like, it doesn't really connect for me.
Yeah.
But like, what did you think?
He's just like a psychopath. And like this is the only person he's ever known. Satoru is the hamster or whatever. The guy, the hamster that survived, that would kind of like, you know, rose up to the top. And
yeah, I guess it's like, so he looks at himself as the Buddha.
I don't know what he sees himself as.
Because I'm like, wait, I understand like that analogy, but how does that connect to the hamster and what you're doing?
Yeah, I don't know. I think it was like a weird, he would see, I don't know exactly how the metaphor works. I mean, look, I don't know.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I'm like a little confused by this metaphor. It's clunky.
Yeah. The way I interpreted it was the story he's referencing is this guy is climbing up a spider's spider web to get out of hell.
Yes.
And then the Buddha like cuts it.
When other people are trying to climb out, he kicks them down and then Buddha cuts them all down.
Yeah.
So my question is, how is that? I got the hamster part. I understood the hamster part.
Yeah.
But I was like, but you're really hammering in this Buddha thing.
Yeah.
Is this needed?
I don't think it's needed. I think it's just kind of like, you know, coloring in the character a little bit. I think it's kind of like he's keeping people in hell with him kind of a thing. But okay, I don't know.
I guess one thing I was just thinking about too, I was like, when he was talking about his brother and then how his brother, like, I think was hurting kids and then kill the girl or something like that. Like his brother was a pedophile, right?
Oh boy, I don't remember that.
Or maybe I was connecting that to the, because I like looked to see the difference between the anime and the manga.
Oh, maybe it was just in the manga. Or maybe it was, I don't know. I just don't remember.
I think there was him talking about how his brother was a pedophile and then he saw his brother like was molesting a girl and then he killed the girl to keep his brother safe.
Oh, yeah, because he just kills kids.
He just kills kids. Yeah, and that's like the backstory of like why, how it started. And then he killed his brother eventually.
Oh.
And I'm like, yo, your family's fucked. Yo, your fucking family dinners must have been wild.
Yeah.
this whole show, we've just been talking about the messy ass families in anime. First of all, Blood of Zeus, messy.
Oh, yeah.
The family in Erased, messy.
Messy.
Fucking all the families in Erased were messy.
Yeah.
What happened to a good nuclear family?
Oh, man. Save it for a shonen.
There was a difference in the manga. The ending's different.
Oh, really?
So what happens is he keeps hiding his memories, and he gets him to go to the woods, and then there's like a standoff on the bridge, and then they burn the bridge so they'll both die. But he recruits everybody else, and then they cut the bridge down, they fall into the water, and they both are fine. I hate that ending too.
So, yeah, I don't really get it.
Yeah, it's, they're both bad in my opinion. And I thought there were some really cool things in this anime. I just never, it never clicked for me.
Yeah, that's fair.
But I don't want to say I hated it. I just said I hated it just because I just wanted to be provocative. It's
Mm-hmm.
But I just thought it was clunky, and I was really like, I thought it was a little clunky to get into it, and then it got clunky as it came along, and I just was like, yo, this. Mm-hmm. I was expecting it to be a Tesla, and what I got was a 2002 Honda Accord,
yeah,
which is my car. And I was like, man, I wanted to be like on a Tesla ride. I wanted that Tesla feel. I thought it was gonna be like fucking everything makes sense. Mm-hmm. It's very intuitive, but just felt kind of weird to me.
Yeah, I guess maybe, and I guess I didn't really think about it, but I think for me, why it works are the like the themes and like the takeaway.
Yeah,
I think it's kind of more the undercurrents of it all that kind of makes me forget the details a little bit. Because I agree with you. The ending, I'm like, I don't. Yeah, you're right. I'm like, I don't know exactly what the plan is.
Yeah, the plan was just like, that's your plan? Because I feel like if any cautious psychopath who's been getting away with it for 10 years would have been like, I'm gonna let you kill yourself. You want to do it? Fine. That's a little too like nice.
Uh-huh.
But then there's the whole thing's like, you're the only one that understands me. I'm like, I don't know.
Yeah.
I feel like I didn't really see that before this, but I don't know.
Yeah. Yeah.
But there are a lot of great things in the show.
Great things. One of my favorite stray moments that I will say is bad, but makes me really laugh. As you know, another unintentional hilarious moment is our main character, Sacha, who's telling that high school girl, he's like, oh, you know, it's like my mom, he's like, you know, my mom was murdered. I'm being framed for all this stuff. And she's like, oh, I totally get it. It's like when my dad was accused of stealing a chocolate bar. And you can just imagine him being like, yeah, it's totally like that.
Oh
my God, stealing a chocolate bar.
Yeah, which was the way she describes the story. It's like, my dad was accused of stealing a chocolate bar. And he said, I didn't do it. Then he got fired. Then my mom divorced him.
Yeah.
And he had to leave town.
I wonder, but I mean...
And I was like, oh my, like, damn.
I do wonder if like, some of these crimes in Japan are just a really big deal.
stealing a chocolate bar
is like, I mean, we just don't know.
It's like driving without a license.
It's just like,
it's kind of like,
what if like for some reason, like Tokyo Drift, everything was legal, but they're like, but were you doing it with a license?
Cause
if not, you gotta go.
You gotta get out of
here. And it's like, yo, we found him driving without a license. He was drifting without a license and he had a trunk full of stolen chocolate. There was heroin there too. We let him go for the heroin, but the chocolate. It wasn't for me. I still would say it's a 6 out of 10. I thought there was a lot of great things in it. Mm. It just feels a little clunky for me, but I think it's worth the watch. If you're willing to like forgive that kind of shit, it's definitely worth the watch.
Yeah, I think I like it. I
wasn't mad that I watched it.
Yeah,
I just was a little confused.
Mm-hmm. It's interesting because I've never. This is one of those shows I saw when it came out.
2016. Yeah.
And liked it. Never spoke to another person about it.
Yeah.
Because it's just one of those shows. It's not the show that like every anime fan has seen. So
I think it's a show that like when I looked online because I was like, I heard there was different. I like read the Wikipedia page and how the manga was different. So I like looked online just to get a quick video of what the differences were. And from what most of the reviews and the comments were positive. So
yeah.
I was like, I think I'm in the minority here.
Mm-hmm.
And, that's fine. I don't think it's not terrible, but it's not, it just was like a little, like I was really like, oh, this is going to be a really dope anime. And there are moments where I'm like, oh, the animation's amazing. And, and like the emotional stakes, I felt them, but, just some of the storytelling, I kind of was like a little thrown off by.
Yeah. It's interesting. I wouldn't have thought about that. So that's kind of a cool, it's kind of like an interesting lens to look back
on. I would recommend it.
I think it's worth checking out, and then if you're in a couple episodes in, you'll probably know.
This is only 12 episodes.
Yeah, I do love that.
Yeah,
I do love that. It's just a nice short story.
Short story.
Yeah,
I would say 6 out of 10, 6.5 out of 10 for me personally.
Yeah, yeah.
But I definitely love it, and I hope you guys don't scrutinize my storytelling too much. I'm fucked. I'm fucking myself with this one.
Dude, we're both fucking ourselves. I
would never be able to work for that guy ever. And I did like the manga element to it. I thought that was cool.
Oh, he's a manga artist.
Yeah, I thought that was cool. Yeah. I really thought that was real cool. And that he was digging deep into his stories. And that's like a good inciting reason why he was like looking into it. I thought that was pretty cool.
Mm-hmm.
That's basically it.
Yeah, that's erased. And then, oh man, I guess next week. Did we say Fooly Cooly? Was that what we're doing?
We could do Fooly Cooly.
Yeah, I can't remember.
Fooly Cooly next week.
Yeah, I'm down for that.
Six episodes.
Yeah, it'll be a lot easier.
Have you seen it yet?
I've seen it. It was something that I watched all in one night.
I haven't watched the newest version.
Oh, the new one?
Yeah, I was too scared to because Fooly Cooly is my favorite anime.
Do you want to do the original first and then...
Yeah, let's do the original first. And then next week we'll do the original... The
remix or whatever.
Remix. And I think there's one after that too.
Oh, really?
I think so. I was scared to watch the remix one because I was like, man, if they ruin this, is it going to ruin...
Yeah.
Because I love Fooly. I've watched Fooly Cooly maybe 10 times.
Oh, okay.
I watched like once a year.
Yeah.
And that shit came out when I first... Like 2006?
I think Fooly Cooly
came out, or at least I watched it through Toonami, or Adult Swim Toonami, when they like were doing it on Saturday nights.
For some reason, I thought it was older, but maybe not.
It might have came out in Japan, and then because I watched the English version first. And so like, I just remember watching Adult Swim. I think it was like, you might be right, maybe 2005, 2004.
Yeah, I don't know.
But I just remember like, I remember where I was sitting in my house when I first saw Fooly Cooly. And I was just like, whoa, what is this? Mm-hmm. Like, it's one of those things because, like, initially, like, Death Note, I mean, before I got into Death Note or anything like that, Dragon Ball Z was, like, my... Dragon Ball Z, Hamtaro, and Tenchi in Tokyo.
Dude, yeah.
Or am I, like, the things that got me in anime. But then, like, Fooly Cooly and Death Note, I think, are the things that made me go, like, oh, I'm a weeb. I'm into this art form hardcore.
Yeah, yeah.
So, yeah. Fooly Cooly next week.
Next week, man.
I'm a gush over this thing.
I'm excited to see it again because I...
It'd be so funny if you like, well, I don't like it.
Well, I remember not really thinking anything of it.
Interesting,
so
yeah.
I am excited to watch it again.
I mean, it's got a cult following and I think whenever you have a cult following, there's a lot of people who are like, this is fine. And then there's people like me who I'm like, nah, this is... Yeah. Some of the best shit ever.
Well, it's really, it's thrown into that, like, you know, greats category. So I am excited to revisit it 10 years later.
I'm going like to be listening to the soundtrack the entire week. Last Dinosaur, baby.
Woo!
Another episode.
That was the episode.
Yeah.
Follow social
Swanky
stuff.
Swanky Opie.
Damian Holmes, two S's. And filling on Canon on Instagram. I think I'll probably start putting clips up there and stuff.
Bye. Be safe.